gentlemen, the next fight is a contest in the featherweight division.
One of the most controversial fighters in Asia, American-born Will the Kill Chope, has had a rollercoaster ride of popularity that has seen him experience incredible heights and devastating lows. Known as the tallest featherweight in the world, Chope left the life he knew behind when he was just 17 years old. Chope spent a year with the military before taking a one-way trip to Thailand, where he discovered his true passion, fighting.
When I was a kid, all I ever wanted to be was a warrior, you know? I wanted to be a warrior, I wanted to be a soldier.
Will's career has taken him across the world and in and out of the UFC. Though his sudden release will forever be a dark cloud hanging over his career, Chope knows his way back to the spotlight, start with the Rebel FC tournament. Looking for redemption in Singapore, the 23-year-old Muay Thai specialist will strive to make an example of Mauricio Dos Santos Jr. Using his destructive knees and elbows to send the Jiu-Jitsu black belt back to Brazil. Mauricio Dos Santos Jr. is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt, a Brazilian MMA champion, and he's coming for blood. While he might not be the most well-known of the Rebel FC Battle Royale competitors, he's certainly the most outspoken. Known as Fatal, Mauricio Dos Santos Jr. doesn't hide the fact he dislikes Will Chope. And what the 1.62-meter Fatal doesn't like, he breaks. Fatal versus Chope will be a David versus Goliath matchup. But the feisty Brazilian will not back down. He knows this is his chance to introduce himself to the world in a big way. And he will not let the chance pass him by. It's a battle of America versus Brazil. Will Chope versus Mauricio Dos Santos Jr.
In the blue corner, from Brazil, fighting out of Centurion Fight Team, Mauricio Fucao Dos Santos Jr.
Mauricio Dos Santos Jr., known as Fucao. And boy, there's been some trash talking in the lead up to this fight, Frank Barker.
Oh, are you kidding me? Man, Mauricio Fucao Dos Santos, I went backstage and I said, oh, I wanted to ask him some questions. And I said, what's your game plan? He goes, I want a war. I want to kill. I'm like, man, that's pretty serious. Game plan tonight is to go to war, as I said. He's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt under Dracolino. His Muay Thai is stellar. Strong wrestling, great boxing. He means business tonight. On the ground, watch out for his rear naked choke. It's brutal. Anyone, he takes someone's back, he finishes. He's here. He's ready. It's going down. It's going to be a war.
In the red corner, from the US of A, fighting out of the Juggernaut Fight Club, please welcome Will the Kill Chope!
Well, he may be from the USA, but spent his last 3 or 4 years here in Asia learning the ropes of mixed martial arts.
Let me tell you something about Will Chope. 3 months training with Arvin out of Juggernaut Fight Club. He's been there for 3 months. He's been training with, you know, with some great guys. Some have been on this card already. With Shafiq, I think he was training with Shafiq, yep, as well. Game plan is to keep it standing. He's going to try and stuff the takedowns. Will Chope is a cerebral fighter. He's becoming more and more scientific. He won't kick high at all unless he's attacking with hands first to set it up, because he doesn't want to run the risk of getting taken down. Watch out for his clinching and his knees, Mike. He wears you down and then takes you down and then chokes you out to sleep. That's the deal with Will the Kill Chope. And I can't wait to see this fight. I've been busting for this. I can't wait. It's going to go down.
Ladies and gentlemen, when the action begins, our referee in charge is Mr. Thomas Fan. Firstly, to my left, fighting out of the blue corner, fighting out of Centurion Fight Club, a submission specialist and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt from Belo Horizonte, Brazil, the WOCS champion, please welcome Fucao Mauricio Dos Santos Jr. Tomorrow, fighting out of the red corner, with a professional fight record of 19 wins with only 7 losses. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, wearing the black and red fight shorts, a Muay Thai expert and former UFC fighter, please welcome Will the Kill Chope! Fighters, two set of cage, please, for final instructions.
He's going to run straight at him. There you go. He wants to close that distance. Look.
Yeah.
He's a sal. Oh, front kick to the chops. Look at Will. He's just waiting.
He's got some range, that's for sure. Will the kill. A featherweight competition, believe it or not. Knockout competition here at Red Bull Fighting Championship.
Dos Santos has got to be really careful. And he's doing the right thing. Like, he's picking his moment, he's taking his time. And when he's ready, he's going to go in. You're going to see looping hands. You're going to see low to the body, high to the head. There it is. There it is. A nice single. Beautiful on that single. Deep as hell. Whoa, he's got him down. He's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt, Mike. This could get really interesting quickly.
Yeah, well, Will Chop, he was telling me, too, that he wanted to strike from distance. Didn't want to get involved on the ground here. So, as you can see, just trying to get to his feet. But, oh, against the black belt madness of Dos Santos.
You know, Chope has got to punish him, you know, if he's going for the, you know, classic. If a wrestler wants to take you down, he may take you down, but you got to punish him along the way. You got to make him pay. You got to make him second guess himself. You got to make him think, well, maybe I want to think twice about going in on that single, you know. If he makes a mistake and leaves his head there, Chope's going to punch it. Like, Chope's okay. Like, right now, he's all right. Yep. But you can see Mauricio right now, he's not thinking of punching him.
Yep.
Mauricio should think about punching him and dropping some elbows. At least he can get him thinking about that while he passes.
Trying to get that butterfly guard going.
Look at that head position right on the jaw. That's classic.
As you said, he wants war. He's going to grind away here. Chop trying to keep his position against the side of the netting.
Dos Santos Jr. is doing a great job in controlling him. You can just see the experience right there. Look at the weight. He's just driving into his chin, just keeping him on his back.
He's 33 years old, Dos Santos. It's his 19th fight. He's 10-8, but loads of experience.
If Chope tries to get up, he's gonna try and use the cage to get up. Here we go. He's going to get up. Oh, is he going to stay down? He's looking for the guillotine. He's reversed it.
Well, he's known for that guillotine.
Oh, he's reversed the position. That was a beautiful move by Chope there.
Very masterful.
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. He's got to be super careful.
Yeah. Oh, he's punishing Dos Santos at the moment, though. Good period here for
he's looking for
Will
an arm.
Just trying to retain his clarity here, Dos Santos. You can see him looking for an opening. As a black belt, he's probably been in this position many times before.
Chope's got to be super careful here, Mike. You know, yes. He does have a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt underneath him. So pick your shots. You know, don't get too over-exuberant. You know, don't get too anxious. You're in the top position. He's stuck against the cage. He's on his back. Just use your leverage, use your weight, use your long levers, those elbows.
What a fantastic first 3 minutes of this fight we've seen.
Dos Santos
on top.
Oh,
really, really? And that's what war's all about.
Some strategy.
Great strategies coming in here.
You're absolutely right, Mike. Excellent point.
Chop. An amazing career. Lost his first five fights, then bang. Got to 19-7. Wants to fight 100 fights. That's his aim. He's a warrior. Bacal trying to
stand
get
up.
Against, yeah. And Chop really giving it here to Dos Santos. Wouldn't have expected this turnaround after a couple of minutes in the fight. Chop showing his toughness.
110 left in this first round, Mike. Chope's doing a great job here. It wasn't what he wanted, but man, he's got the top position and he's scoring.
Yep.
He's stealing this round.
Real determined stuff. This is going to set both of these athletes. You can see already the strain showing on them. Chop off.
Oh, he's going for a leg lock.
Oh.
He's going for that heel hook. Ooh, he's going to spin out. He was out. He's out.
Well done from Chop.
Oh, but it's back on top.
Yeah, 42 seconds left in the round. Important time here for Chop. He's had a good period. What an interesting clash this is of styles. And
30 seconds, Mike. What an exciting round one, Mike.
Dos Santos now on top. Past the Chop, just so much taller. It's a huge advantage, even on the ground.
Absolutely.
There's 10 seconds left. What a brilliant first round this has been. A battle royal indeed. As the Hooter goes for the end of round one. And that is masterful stuff from both these athletes. look at him concentrating, the look of concentration on his face.
Absolutely.
And but working. You can
see, true, that's true. But, you know, I'd like to see Dos Santos Jr., while he's on top, if he's on the ground, throw some leather.
Yes.
Throw some elbows, just to get Chope to think about striking a little bit and maybe open up the pass. He's got the skills to do it. He's got the skills to finish. But I think Chope is well and truly ready for whatever Dos Santos throws at him on the ground, just in submissions only.
Dangerous moment.
Oh, very dangerous moment. Exciting stuff, Mike.
Yeah, really.
Round two.
And Frank Barker calling this one for you at Rebel Fighting Championship.
I think conditioning is going to play a big part. If this goes deep into the third with a similar kind of strategy, it's going to be... See, I think Dos Santos Jr., you know, if he slows down a little bit, it's going to be an easy pickings for Will Chope. Let's see what happens.
The lanky madness.
Oh,
Dos Santos
nice left
moving
hook.
In for the counter.
Oh, nice right hand. Oh, beautiful knee. Right in front of us here, Mike.
Yeah, fantastic to see.
Beautiful double leg takedown by Dos Santos Jr.
But again, let's see if Chope can just keep his head.
He's got wrist control on that left side. He's going to look for a triangle. He's going to hold him and throw some elbows. Nice elbows from the bottom.
Nasty nuts there being cracked from the elbow of Chope.
It's a sharp elbow, too.
It is. And that's it. Dos Santos just having so much trouble passing guard with the huge, lanky body of Chope.
He's got to get busy now, you know. Dos Santos Jr. has got to start doing something. He's inside his guard. He's winning, according to the judges. Oh, nice. He's looking at doing that bullfighter pass. He's got the neck. Has he got anything left? Oh, he let him stand up.
Relentless stuff, though, from Dos Santos at the start of round two.
Generally, when you see him get that front head control on the ground and they're a ground specialist and they just hang on, they're tired.
Yeah.
And that gives Chope a chance to stand. He looks a bit tired, looks a bit wary now, Dos Santos.
Yep. Blowing hard here.
If he doesn't keep moving, those high head kicks are coming.
Yep. The lanky madness.
3 months of juggernaut's going to do that. Look, he just ate a body kick. Nice left hook.
Tried it again.
Beautiful single leg.
Yeah.
Oh, nice well sprawl. Beautiful sprawl by Chope. He's on top now.
Yeah, just holding off though. Come on, let's get it on our toes, he's saying. And the crowd love that. Telling the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt to get on his feet. Let's fight it here, says Chope. Probably a wise move. Just that height distance. They're winding them up, isn't he? But
he's got to set him up with his hands first, or else
yes.
It's too telegraphic.
Yep.
It's too obvious.
Yep. And that's what his plan was, too. See the hands first,
but you
then
know what?
The legs.
Will's... Oh, he just ate a bit of that shin.
Yeah.
You know, Will's head is up and straight, because, you know, when you fight a smaller opponent,
yep.
You find that your head is a little held up. You got to lower your shoulders and lower your frame a little bit so you're covering your jawline. A couple of times, Dos Santos Jr. has had access to that chin. He nearly landed a couple of good left hooks, but it looks bad for him right now.
Good elbows there from Chope.
2 minutes left, Mike.
So over halfway through this fight, and it's just flown. It's been an amazing clash. This Chope really showing his experience now.
His conditioning too, like he's looking fresher out of the two, Mike.
He's playing the crowd too. Oh, there was some trash talk here. The Dos Santos
he's tired, Mike.
Calling Chope a drunken giraffe and Chope replying saying he's going to beat Dos Santos better than Germany beat Brazil in the Football World Cup.
Look at that. He sets that up well every time.
Yep. But Chope managing to play it well on the ground.
Dos Santos has cut. He's got his back. Oh, full mount, Will Chope!
So open him up here, Dos Santos.
He's got nice recovery from the guard, but Dos Santos Jr. is tired.
Yeah, really
this
tired.
This is looking hard. This is looking bad. He's been very, very gallant in his efforts. We'll see what he can muster up now. 1 minute to go in this round, Mike.
Now, Brazilian fighters haven't had much luck in Rebel. We had a couple of them fighting in the first one. Well, Alberto Mina, he was the exception. Amazing performance. But Vinicius went down. Silvio Romero went down earlier tonight. Not looking too good here for Dos Santos. It's a hell of a flight, of course, to Singapore. It's a good 30-hour job. Whereas Chop just signaling for him. Arvin Lawani.
He wants him to go after
yeah,
him.
Yeah, just going in here.
He wants him to finish.
Yeah, going
He's
in for the kill.
He's got 23 seconds, Mike. See, he might go up the middle with that front kick. You never know.
Ooh, oh, there it is. Telepathic from Frank Barker.
No, I knew. I know the future. I've got a crystal ball. Come on. 30 years Dos Santos in stand-up martial arts will do that.
Into the last few seconds of round two, though. But Dos Santos showing he's got a little bit of fight left in him. Yeah, the Terrier from Brazil. But, wow, this has been an impressive performance from Will Chope.
It's also been an impressive performance to me by Dos Santos Jr. I mean, look at the size difference. I mean, I know they're the same weight and all. I get that. I understand. It's a David and Goliath situation here right now.
And Ishida going up next. The winner of that fight will take on the winner of this.
You can see Dos Santos Jr. bridging that gap and getting the takedown. I think that might have been early. I think maybe in round one. I think this might have been round. You can see the size difference. I mean, that's unbelievable. It looks like me out there. Again, now you can start to see that he's on the end of the lever.
Yeah.
You can see that
well,
he's
set that flurry up with the hands. It was a great point you made there. A few telegraphic. So into round three.
Third and final round.
Round three, Mike. I think Will's looking for the finish here.
Really? He's in the driving seat?
Yeah. Dos Santos Jr. He's going to do everything he can. He's a Brazilian man. He's going to throw. He's going to die trying.
Yep.
There he goes. He's going to throw that looping overhand. Will's got to still be have his wits about him until he tags him and slows him down.
Yep.
See, those punches are coming slower and slower. He's tired. He's got the underhooks.
Good combination there from Dos Santos, though.
He's going to pop out the back. He's going to pop out the back. He's going to pop out the back. There he goes. It's getting slippery. Oh, nice. He just shrugs him off, throws
Good
him off.
Good strength from Chop. Again, Chop's got to be careful here.
See Dos Santos Jr. just move away from the cage there. Yep. He needed some space to work. See, he needed it.
Yeah.
But very, very wise on Will Chope to push him back in there. Minimize his ability to turn his shoulders to get angles for arm bars and triangles and escapes.
Dos Santos, well, he's had experience beating UFC fighters. He's downed Wagner Campos earlier this year. And he's a gutsy performer. You can tell he's never going to give up.
He's looking for that heel. Oh, that's deep. Oh, my God, that's deep.
Chope
right again. Oh, nice
what a
escape.
Great escape.
Beautiful escape.
Slippery work from Chope. He's shown a couple of times now he's been able to just slip those leg hooks.
Dos Santos Jr., you know, he's still trying. It's 3:30 left in the third round. He's still trying to finish the fight. That's incredible. Just shows you the heart of the Brazilians. Just controlling those hips.
Chope really a child of Asia now.
Because of his length, he doesn't have to pass the guard.
No.
Look at him. He could actually be another meter in front and he'd still be able to punch him, you know?
He's crazy, isn't he?
It's incredible. It's incredible what leverage he's got. Look, look, look. He's starting to bring in the elbows from his butterflies. That's amazing.
Yeah. Doesn't happen too often, does it?
Dos Santos Jr.
30 centimeters.
Dos Santos trying to sit up, trying to put him in the cocoon, which is a sitting up position from butterfly guard. Still trying. Will Chope just tapping away like Nick and Nate Diaz do. Again going for that heel hook.
Oh, this one looks a bit tougher too.
It might be.
Can't escape the first grip.
He can't. I don't think he can get his hands together to finish it.
Yeah, Chope showing a bit of concern, but oh.
No, not at all. He knew where he was.
Yep.
He knew where he was. It's pretty safe there, Mike.
Yep.
It looks terrible, but he knew where he was. He can feel where if the heel's not hooked, he's okay.
2 minutes left of this fight. Rebel Fighting Championship. The Battle Royal. Mm. Got Miguel Torres coming up next.
Can you imagine if Will submits? He submits Dos Santos.
A feather in the cap, that's
imagine
for sure.
A black belt from Brazil. Yeah.
Another one for the highlights reel, that's for sure.
He really wore him down, didn't he? He just persisted with his game plan and just continued to execute and just keep follow up. You know, keep standing up, keep banging away, keep throwing those hands. you know, wrestling, reversing positions off the ground, escaping footlocks. He's done the work. He's obviously done the work. Arvin from Juggernaut's done obviously an incredible job with Will over the last 3 months. It really shows.
Looking down the barrel at 2-0 for the Juggernaut Fight Club tonight. Shafiq earlier this evening finishing his opponent. So far a good night's work. We've got a minute to go though. Anything can happen. Dos Santos, as you say, is never giving up. Never giving up. There's always a chance when he's on the ground here.
It's going to be a really long minute, Mike, for Dos Santos Jr., but these Brazilians are unbelievable. They've got hearts like lions. They will go out on their shield, there's no doubt about it. Quitting is not an option. Look, stands up again.
He's learned so much.
Oh, eats a big knee.
Big knee, and now he's retreating.
Oh, Dos Santos here. That lead takes a big breath, took a big breath there. He might try and go for a head kick here. He might set him up with a jab. He's looking. Nice. Dos Santos is in shape, man. He just keeps coming.
Yeah. Oh, another knee to the head. Oh.
Final 30 seconds. Oh, he's split him open. He's busted him open now, Mike. That left eye is busted open.
Yeah, and
look out for
now.
That head kick. Oh. Look for that head kick.
Tries.
Oh, there it is. Watch to the front, kick up the middle. There
last
it is.
Ten.
Watch another head kick. It might come up. Here we go.
Chop. Showing.
Ah, oh, beautiful, beautiful.
A little lack
beautiful.
Of humility here in the last second.
Oh,
seconds,
so. No.
From where he's come from, 5 defeats in his first 5 fights. You see there, just slipping the leg lock and heel hook of Dos Santos. Just coming at him. Staring down the barrel. Now, Dos Santos wanted to go to war. And that's what he got, a battle royale.
From the red corner, USMA, Will Lampeel.
So there it is, confirmation of the final.
Thank you, Singapore. Thank you to my gym, Juggernaut Fight Club. Yo, the best gym in Singapore. They're making me a great fighter.
Congratulations again. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Will the Kill Joe.